All right, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. It is I, ChimneySift11, and today we're going to be talking about animal pens. So we're back again here in sort of this like village tutorial world. A couple weeks ago, I showed you guys in a video on how to make these custom farms. If you haven't checked out that video, make sure to do so. I'll put a link to that in the description. But today we're going to be focusing on the topic of animal pens. So most of you guys in your world, you probably start out when you're penning animals or corralling animals. You kind of, I would imagine, I do this, everybody probably does this when you're starting out, that you make a design very simple like this. You grab some fences, you put your animals inside, you light it up with some torches, and maybe you even put a piece of carpet on one of the top of the fence posts so that you can jump up and feed them, or if you get stuck inside, you can jump out. Obviously here we have the standard, you know, fence gate, but today I wanna show you guys three unique designs so that you can upgrade and sort of stylize your animal pens and make them look better than just the basic one you see right here. So obviously the functionality of these are gonna be up to you. If you wanna just have animals inside to breed them, then that's fine. Maybe you have them in sort of a holding cell and you wanna use it as like, I don't know, maybe you got minecarts running through and you're whisking away sheep as you take them somewhere. I don't know. The functionality is up to you, but I'm just going to be showing you guys sort of the builds and designs for each one of these. And like I said, we have three. And the third one is honestly really cool. So make sure you guys stick around for that one. So here we go. Let's jump into this and let's get started. All right. So the first design is pretty similar to the custom farms that I made a few weeks ago. So basically with this one, I just did wood. You can kind of do whatever you want. But the idea here is we have a sheep pen, and again, you can put any animals inside here that you want. But basically what I did was I just took oak logs, I took some spruce fences, some spruce slabs, and then I just kind of mixed in different, like, you know, trapdoors. Like I've got the oak trapdoors here, we got some lanterns, we got spruce trapdoors, and I kind of just did a similar pattern and variety of heights that I would do if I were to be making like one of those custom farms over there. And so basically you can convert any of those custom farms from that tutorial that I did a couple weeks ago, and you could just put animals inside if you wanted. But I think this looks pretty cool. It's got a nice rustic look to it. You could obviously use something like stone or whatever. We also have spruce planks in here. And then on the ground, I just have some things like coarse dirt and podzol to sort of mix things up a little bit. Obviously the sheep, if they're gonna be sheared, if you're gonna be coming in here and shearing them, then they're gonna be eating some of the grass as well, like this one just did, and they're gonna be regenerating their wool. But obviously you wanna make sure as well that this place is lit up, so I've got torches and stuff. But in terms of this video, I don't wanna actually like, I'm not gonna be actually building anything, I'm just gonna be showing you guys some of these designs. So feel free to pause the video whenever you feel is necessary. But yeah, I kinda just, basically what I did was I went around and like I did in the tutorial for the farms, kinda picked out my shape, I laid out the blocks of the shape, and then I started to build blocks up and do different heights and varieties. Now, one trick when you are building in this style, make sure that you have it so that if you are varying the heights, just make sure that you have it so that obviously the animals can't escape. It's an easy thing to forget. It's also an easy thing to forget to actually, on the outside, have a spot where something could get in. You don't want other things to get in as well, like a creeper or something like that. So, you know, even right here, things can't get in, you can't jump over the fence. So this is secure, but you gotta make sure that you have a secure area for all your animals, because we don't want anything bad to happen to them. That's why you're putting them inside of an animal pen, right? So this design is fairly simple, but very effective, and I think it looks pretty cool. All right, so the next design is more of sort of like a stable or barn design, but it's more of like an open design, I would say. So it's not quite a barn, but this design is, again, very, very simple to do. Basically here, we have a center post right here out of spruce wood, and then four blocks over with a three block gap in the middle, we have another post that's just one, two, three high. This one's gonna be four high, I think. One, two, three, four. Yeah, I think this one's three high, or sorry, four high. I can't get my numbers correct today. But basically I've got two separate things here. So you could put, I've got cows in one and cows in the other, but you could split this up. You could put like pigs in one, cows in the other. You could put horses in both. You could do horses on one, cows on the other. It doesn't matter. It's up to you guys what you want to do. I've decorated the floor with coarse dirt, podzol, gravel, and cobblestone. And on the back wall, we've got a line of cobblestone, which actually, I think because I did this on a hillside, I actually sort of built this. Yeah, so I actually pulled some of the rocks down and tried to make this look a little bit more rocky to give it a bit more texture. But on the back side here, we've got two blocks high of fences and then a sloping roof that essentially just, I don't know, you guys can do the roof however you want, but if you want to do it just how I have it here, we have a full block on top of these, of the first, of the middle posts here of spruce wood, and these are spruce planks. And then going down from there, I basically just altered it. So I took some slabs and went down here, and then I put a slab on the underside. And then right here is stairs. So there's a stair right here. And then over here I have slabs, but it's another, you could just do another block here, followed by a half slab right here, and then block on the corners. So I didn't keep slabs all the way across. So I kind of left this spot a little bit more open, but I do have the blocks on the corners so that we can hang lanterns off of them, which I think looks pretty cool. I've got the roof lit up with some torches. And again, this design is pretty simple. We've got our gates right here and just some little grass decoration outside. But yeah, definitely adding, I should mention that I also have some soul soil in on this one as well to make things look a little bit more muddy. So speaking of muddy, let's get into our last design. And this one is really, really cool. So over here, this is a pig pen. And I've wanted to do one of these designs for a really long time. And there's a secret block that we're using here that you can't actually see. So the pigs are stuck inside of this area here. You're probably like, wait, how is this possible? It's just a one high area. Well, if I knock out the carpet here, you'll notice that we have honey blocks underneath. And honey blocks are special because you can't actually jump on them. So what it does is it basically keeps any mob that's inside this area, as long as you have the border, you know, bordered with honey blocks, it makes sure that nothing can jump out, including myself. I can't jump out either. So that is kind of problematic, especially if you're going to be, you know, coming in here. But the good news is, as a player, you can sprint and jump out as well, which, you know, the mobs can't sprint jump or whatever. So you can jump out of the two block spot. But from right here and all of these areas where you see the brown carpet, there's honey underneath. So what this is it basically is like a little pig pen. It's like a little mud pig pen, and the pigs will stay in here. They will not escape, which is really, really cool. So this is a super creative and fun way to sort of pen and keep your animals in one area. And I just wanted to share these three simple designs with you guys today in this video. So if you guys add any of these designs to your world, or maybe if you're a member of my Patreon server and you add something like this into the Patreon server, please guys, send me your designs. We have a Discord. If you haven't joined our Discord yet, the link is down below. I try and get our whole community involved in the Discord, and you guys are free to send me pictures of your Minecraft designs anytime you want in the Discord. Also, Twitter works as well. I love if you guys send me pictures and that stuff on Twitter. So I love seeing you guys take inspirational videos like this and apply them to your world and put a little twist on them. And I love like retweeting or responding to those types of things if you guys send those to me. So anyways, guys, with that being said, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you enjoyed it. Make sure if you're new that you subscribe, click that bell as well so you get notifications. And if you enjoyed the video, please be sure to hit the like button. And also, guys, if you're interested in joining an awesome server that has over 70 people, we have a Patreon server. So if you want to learn more about that and learn how you can support my channel and join an amazing server and get some awesome rewards for doing so, just click the link down in the description below. Guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace. Real quick, I'd like to give a huge thanks to all my amazing patrons for helping make this video possible. And a special thanks to Zebra Panda, Steamer546 for the win, Lucas P, Michael D, Kyle J, Mr. MC Amazing, Blade Hunter, and Rex Minecraft. Thank you all so much for your support. Guys, if you're interested in helping support me and the content that I create through Patreon, click the link down below and you can see your name here at the end of another video. Thanks so much for watching, guys.